peace. Certainly, peace is a part of Luke 12. I love that whenever the disciples were to go into a home, they were to say peace. But I hold the finger, two fingers up, because it is what is critical for you and I to really die to flesh and to live the Spirit, for us to be engaged in the going of being an ambassador, for us to do resistance training. It requires not doing it alone. Honestly, I believe if you are trying to live your faith all by yourself, your faith is probably not very vibrant. It's not very effective. It's not going to go very far. Why? In the words of Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 8, because two are better than one, because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who has no one to help him up. How can one keep warm alone? But two can do so. I just got back from a 37-mile backpacking trip. And 37 miles is a pretty big jaunt. We had about over 7,000 feet elevation gain. And in that journey, I know that had I been by myself, it would have been, it was grueling, but had I been myself, it would have been more than grueling. I don't know if I could have made it. Probably, you know, I might have been able to eke it out. But oh my goodness, it went from just a challenge to a pleasure. It went from something that I could enjoy to something I could share. Your faith is a journey. It's a lot more than 37 miles. It's the rest of your life. And if you are struggling in your faith right now, I would almost guarantee I could say that you don't have someone you can share that struggle with, or you're not accessing the someone you could share that struggle with. Two are better than one. That's why Jesus sent the disciples out in twos, because he knew that. He knew that he created us for community. He created us for relationship. He built us to be better together than we are by ourselves. It's no wonder that the book of Acts takes that same model, and as the church grows, its leaders grow because they go, not alone, but in pairs. Barnabas and Paul, then Paul and Barnabas. Paul and Titus, Judas and Titus, Timothy and Erastus. Over and over, they were sent out in twos because we need one another. Today, as we end our devotions and we think about our faith and where it goes from here, and whether or not we're going to be people that do more than pray, but do more than pray, that are involved, that are going, that are doing resistance training, I want to challenge you. You're not going to make a great disciple if you're not with another great disciple. Who is it that God's placed in your life that you can walk with, talk with, share the load with, bear the burden with? Because God wants us to be like iron that sharpens iron. He wants us to be people that recognize that we're going to be more significant, more powerful, more effective when we refuse to be lone rangers. Resist the compulsion in our culture. Resist the propensity of your flesh to be a lone ranger. Even the lone ranger had Tonto. Who do you have? This week, even today, text someone and say, hey, can we spend some more time following along with Pastor Jeff's devotions, studying scripture together, joining another group? But I would like you to help me be a better version of myself, because we won't get there all by ourselves. I'll see you this next weekend, and I look forward to seeing you in the devotions, and I want to see someone by your side. Love you. God bless you. See you soon.